गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। ओम। टुडे इज संडे 30th। सो गीता, सो द फिफ्थ चैप्टर 14th एंड 15th टुगेदर वी आर सीइंग। We discussed a little and we'll complete it and most probably we'll go to the next verse also. So, nakartrutvam nakarmani lokasya srujati prabhu nakarma phalasanyogam swabhavastu pravartate. Ishvara means the truth in its nature, it doesn't create. Nakartrutvam nakarmani, Prabhu the Paramatma doesn't create, or it creates neither karta nor karma nor karma phala. So karta, see, we find here, we find that I am a karta, I am an agent of action. Karma, I perform karma and I come to receive the karma phala. So this taking myself to be karta is a matter of our experience, that we perform karmas and we come to the results. This karta, karma, karma phalam, these three are not really existing. Like in dream we do not find whatever we experience there during our dream. Whatever we experience during our dream are not really existing, nor they are really happening. They neither exist nor really happen. They only appear to be there. It is only a thought. You only think about yourself, that I am an individual. I am an individual doer of action. I am an individual is only a thought, not your real nature. See, this is an interesting thing. So this difference alone is taught here. Whatever the thought says, whatever thinking I have, I think that really is. Here he says it doesn't exist. That is not the actual existence. It is only a thought. Like you see the snake, but the snake doesn't exist there. What really exists is only a rope. You may think as a snake, but during that thought, you think the snake is there because you are in the thought alone. You identify with the thought. Since you are in the thought, you see only the thought. You are not seeing the reality. You are not seeing the reality because you are seeing a thought alone. You are within the thought. You identify with the thought. Therefore, what you identify with, you see it. You identify with the thought, therefore you see the thought alone. And when you, because of your identification, you take the thought to be existing there. The thought of snake alone as the existence of a snake. Thought of a snake is not an existence of a snake. Thought of a snake is only my perception. Similarly here, that in our dream, I am an individual is what I think. Since I identify with the thought, I feel that I am a doer. And I am also doing. At the moment, every moment, whenever I do something, eating, talking, drinking, and then looking, all these things I see, I have been undergoing various activities. I am subject to change. I am undergoing various movements, various changes. I am subject to changes. ओके, दीज चेंजेस विल लीड टू मी एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ दिस एक्शन आई रीच अ रिजल्ट. ओके, सो आई एम ए डूअर, आई डू समथिंग एंड आई रीच अ पॉइंट द रिजल्ट ऑफ माई एक्शन. सो दिस इज अवर एक्सपीरियंस. Our experience is not a reality, but only a thought. That's why he says, Prabhu nasrujati, kartrutvam, all these things, nasrujati, utpadayati, prabhu ratma. Okay. Na kartrutvam svataha. I'm just reading out the Bhashya statement. Napi karmani. रथ घट प्रासादादीन ईप्सिततमानि लोकस्य सृजति उत्पादयति प्रभुः आत्मा नापि रथादि कृतवतस्तत्फलेन संयोगं न कर्मफलसंयोगं यदि किञ्चिदपि स्वतो न करोति न कारयति च देही. सो आत्मा इन इट्स नेचर. सो व्हाट वी सी इज वी इंपोज एंड सी we mistake and see. The very sense of individuality is a mistaken, a thought of misunderstanding about my real existence. The way I exist is not as a karta. See, the way, the reality or the existence is not karta, but the perception is karta. See the difference. I perceive myself to be karta, but I don't exist as karta. I perceive myself to be doing, but I don't exist as I don't exist as an action. Though I perceive myself as undergoing, I perceive myself as undergoing an action, undergoing a change, but I don't exist as that. And I perceive as getting a result, as a result of that karma, reaching a result. Okay, I reach a result. But in my real nature, I don't get to a new result or a new experience. I am just what I am. Nanu kartruvagilla. Nani iruvadu chaitanyatmakata nirvikara chaitanya ananda swarupanage. Sushuptiyalli hegiddeno hage. I exist as that. But I perceive as a karta. Nanu kartruvagi tilkoltini, but nanu iruvadu kartruvagi alla. Nanu karma maduttiddanante nanage anisuttade, adare karma maduvadu andre parinama honduvadu, vikara honduvadu, adare tanna swarupadalli nanu parinama honduttailla. ಪರಿಣಾಮದ ಫಲವಾಗಿ ಒಂದು ಕರ್ಮಫಲ ಅಂದರೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಅನುಭವಕ್ಕೆ ತಲುಪುತ್ತೇನೆ. ಆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಹೊಸ ಅನುಭವವೇನೂ ತಲುಪುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ತಾನು ಇರುವುದು ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಸ್ವರೂಪವಾಗೇ ಇರುತ್ತಾನೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ಕರ್ತೃ ಕರ್ಮ ಕರ್ಮಫಲ. ಕರ್ಮಫಲ ಅಂದರೆ ಒಂದು ಭೋಕ್ತ ಆಗುವುದು. ಸೊ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಕರ್ತ, ಬಿ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಕರ್ಮ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಕರ್ಮಫಲಂ, ದೀಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಮೈ ರಿಯಲ್ ನೇಚರ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ಹೌ ಐ ಪರ್ಸೀವ್. They are only perceptions about myself. ಅದು ನನ್ನ ಕುರಿತಿನ ಅನಿಸಿಕೆಗಳೇ ಹೊರತು, ಅದು ಅನಿಸಿಕೆನೇ ಹೊರತು ಇರುವಿಕೆ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಏಕೆ, ಹೇಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತದೆ? ಅನಿಸಿಕೆ ಆದರೆ ಅದು ಒಂದು ಅವಸ್ಥೆಯಲ್ಲಿರುವುದು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಅವಸ್ಥೆಗೆ ಬಿದ್ದು ಹೋಗುತ್ತದೆ. ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ವೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಫೇಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಡ್ರೀಮ್. And what we find in dream also doesn't come in the waking. And the waking and dream experiences, both of them are not there in deep sleep. Okay, so therefore, in deep sleep, I am neither a waking karta, and I have neither waking karma and waking karma phalam. Nor the dream karta, dream karma and dream karma phalam. None of them exist for me because I am free from them. Okay. therefore nakartrutvam nakarmani lokasya srijati prabhu nakarma phala sanyogam. Then why swabhavastu pravartate, they are only perceptions. What is swabhava? Swabhava is only avidya swabhava. That means avidya is a misunderstanding and adhyasa. Swabhava is adhyasa. ನಾವು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಪಾಠ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಗೀತಾ. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಅನಾವಶ್ಯಕ ಅನಿಸುತ್ತದೆ ನಮ್ಮ ವೇದಾಂತ ಸಾರ. ಅದೇನು ಸುಗಮ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡುವುದೇ ಒಳ್ಳೆಯದು. ಆ ಎರಡು ಮುಗಿದ ನಂತರ ಗೀತಾಕ್ಕೆ ಬರಬಹುದು. ಯಾರೋ ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬರಿಗೋಸ್ಕರ ಶುರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ, ಅವರಿಗೇನು ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಅವರಿಗೇನು ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಅದರಿಂದ ನಾವು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಪಾಠ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅನಾವಶ್ಯಕ ನಮ್ಮ ಪಾಠಗಳಿಗೆ ಅಡ್ಡಿ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಳುವುದು. ಅದರಿಂದ ನನಗನ್ಸುತ್ತದೆ ಅವರೇನು ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ವಿದೇಶಿಯರಿಗೋಸ್ಕರ ಶುರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಅವರೇನು ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ನಾವು ಮತ್ತೆ ನಮ್ಮ ವೇದಾಂತ ಸಾರ ಸುಗಮ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಅದು ಬೇಗ ಮುಗಿಯುತ್ತದೆ. ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಇದು ಗೀತಾಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಏನು ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಡಿಲೇ ಮಾಡುವುದೇಕೆ? ಇದು ಒಂದು ನೋಡ್ತೀನಿ, ಒಂದು ವಾರ ಮುಂದಿನ ವಾರ ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ. ಈ ವಾರ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಗೀತಾ ಆಗಲಿ, ಈಗ ಶುರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಲ್ಲ, ಗೀತನೇ ನಡೆಯಲಿ. ಮುಂದಿನ ಭಾನುವಾರ ನಮ್ಮ ವೇದಾಂತ ಸಾರವೋ ಅಥವಾ ಸುಗಮಾನೋ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಯಾವುದು ಮಾಡೋಣ ಎಂದು ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ. ಮುಂದೆ ಅದೇ ಮುಂದುವರೆಸೋಣ. ಇವತ್ತು ಮಾತ್ರ ಈ ಎರಡು ಶ್ಲೋಕಗಳನ್ನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ. ಸೊ ಅದು ನಿಜವಾದ ಇರುವಿಕೆಯನ್ನು ತಪ್ಪಾಗಿ ತಿಳುವುದೆ. ವಿ ಟೇಕ್ ರಾಂಗ್ಲಿ, ವಿ ಸಿ ರಾಂಗ್ಲಿ, ರಾಂಗ್ಲಿ ಮಿಸ್ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಅಧ್ಯಾಸ. ಇನ್ ಅದರ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎನ್ ಅಧ್ಯಾಸ. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಎ ಡ್ರೀಮ್, ದ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಡ್ರೀಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡ್ರೀಮ್ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವ್ಯಾಲಿಟಿ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಮಿಸ್ಪರ್ಸೆಪ್ಷನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಮೈ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್, ಮೈ ರಿಯಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್, ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ಲೈಕ್ ಇಟ್, ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೋಟ್ಲಿ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಇಟ್. ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ವೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದ ಡ್ರೀಮ್ ಅಲೋನ್ ಎನಿವೇ. ಸೊ ಜಾಗ್ರತ್ತು ಸ್ವಪ್ನವೇ, ಏಕೆಂದರೆ ಜಾಗ್ರತ್ತು ಸ್ವಪ್ನ ಹಾಗೆಯೇ ತನ್ನನ್ನು ಇನ್ನೊಂದಾಗಿ ತಪ್ಪಾಗಿ ತಿಳಿಸುತ್ತೆ, ತಪ್ಪಾಗಿ ತೋರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ತಪ್ಪಾಗಿ ತಿಳಿಸುತ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಆದರೆ ನಿಜಸ್ವರೂಪದಲ್ಲಿ ಇವು ಯಾವವೂ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ. ನಾದತ್ತೆ ಕಸ್ಯಚಿತ್ ಪಾಪಂ ನ ಚೈವ ಸುಕೃತಂ ವಿಭುಃ ಅಜ್ಞಾನೇನಾವೃತಂ ಜ್ಞಾನಂ ತೇನ ಮುಹ್ಯಂತಿ ಜಂತವಃ. ನಾವು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಇದೇ ವಿಷಯವನ್ನು ಇನ್ನೂ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ ಹೇಳುತ್ತಾ ಮುಂದಿನ ಶ್ಲೋಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಮೋರ್ ಎಲಾಬರೇಟ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಶ್ಲೋಕ. ಇನ್ ವ್ಯವಹಾರ ವಿ ಸಿ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಿ ಡು ಪುಣ್ಯ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪಾಪ. ಓಕೆ, ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಪುಣ್ಯ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪಾಪ. ಜೀವ ಡಸ್ ಕರ್ಮ. So if he does punya, he receives it and gives the result accordingly. Punya maadiddare adakke ishvara swikarisi adakke anugunavagi karma phala kodtane. And then papam also, the papam is the adharmic work, and then unrighteous vice, the act of vice and act of virtue, both good and bad, good karma and bad karma. So if a person does any bad karma, bad means a selfish and harmful and hurtful to others, and selfish karma is papa. Selfish as well as harmful and hurtful to others is a papa. And what is good to others, beneficial to others, helping others is called punya. So this punya and papa, both virtuous action and vicious action, or good and bad actions, these things Ishvara doesn't receive any. In Vyavaharika Drishti, it is generally stated that Ishvara considers your Punya and Papa. From the Vyavaharika Drishti, in empirical life, whatever Jiva does, good or bad, Ishvara notes those karmas, he watches our karmas, ನಾವು ಮಾಡುವ ಕರ್ಮಗಳನ್ನು ನೋಡುತ್ತಾನೆ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅನುಗುಣವಾಗಿ ಫಲ ಕೊಡ್ತಾನೆ ಅಲ್ಲವೇ. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೌ ವಿ ಸೀ ಇನ್ ದ ಎಂಪಿರಿಕಲ್ ಲೈಫ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಹಿ ಸೇಸ್, that Ishwara noting your karma and giving a result accordingly is only an empirical thing, but not an absolute reality. He is talking from an absolute reality. Here we have to note one thing. So there are two, why two? There are three levels. One is very atheistic level. Atheist also thinks that there is no good and bad karma, there is no papa and punya, and he thinks that there is no life, next life, after this life, there is no life, there is no Ishwara who creates, there is no law of karma. An atheist nastikanu hage punya papa illa, Ishwaran illa, karma phalavilla, ee vande janma endu tilkoltane. Atheist also thinks that there is only this janma which I am living. Once I die, I don't continue to exist. I have neither a next birth nor next loka. So an atheist also thinks like that, believes like that. Nastikanu hage nambuttane. Andre ee vande janma, ee vande life ashte. Afterwards, that means he doesn't believe in the atma independent of the body. Atma independent of the body and is connected to next life. He believes neither in the Purva Janma nor in the next Janma. So this is an atheist stand, Nastikana stand. That's okay. Adandu. But Shastra adu helta illa. Shastra says that we are not talking as like an atheist. So atheist is wrong because he doesn't understand the very nature of that. When I find myself in this bodily condition, this itself proves that I had a previous life. Because of that, I came into this particular specific conditions. The specific conditions I live in are governed by my past karma. Because this is not an accidental life. Nothing, no janma, no birth is accidental. So since the present life I have, it is a product of past, because there is a basically cause and effect relationship. So otherwise you cannot explain the differences in life. Some people are rich, some people are poor, some people are educated, some people are illiterate. So all these differences cannot be explained unless you see some past karma. Once you accept the past karma, then it requires a past janma, and then atma is more than the body. All these things come into picture. Otherwise, there is no reason to be good. You can just exploit and live comfortably and happily. So there is no reason to be a good person and do good karma. Because you can just live as you like. If there is no next birth, and if the atma is not there independent of the body, the life like an animal is good enough. You live like animals, and no punya, papa, and no Ishwara, no karma phalam, nothing. But that is against our experience, and also it destroys all our morality and religious thinking, and it only represents a very narrow animalistic outlook. So that doesn't explain anything. And even your explanation, you are using logic, argument is also waste. Because you don't need argument to live like animals. To live like animals, you don't need even argument, you don't need a philosophy, you don't need to discuss. Therefore, atheistic philosophy is a contradiction. If you have a philosophy, means you think. Once you think, then there is you are a thinker. Thinking means cause and effect and all that. Once you accept cause and effect thinking, then you are a human being. Human being has got a past janma, future janma, and all that comes into picture. It is an animal alone doesn't need logic. Do animals argue that yes, I have got this is my right to kill others and eat? No argument, only kill each other. That's enough. Whoever is powerful, he lives. But animals don't argue. Tiger doesn't argue. It goes and kills others and lives comfortably. That's all. It doesn't care for anything. So when your brain is there, when your mind is thinking, then you are a conscious being. Then you think of cause and effect relationship. Then extend the cause and effect relationship to the whole cosmos. then the all other life, past life, future life, everything comes into picture. Therefore the religious life of next birth, God is giving result of you, he accepts your karma, all that is correct. But all that is in empirical life alone, empirical in the sense, in a certain level alone. In a certain level, as long as you are an individual, there is an Ishvara and you are an individual and there is a world and there is an interaction and even good and bad and punya, papa and all. So here he is talking in another level, an absolute level again. So in the empirical level, one is a two atheistic stand, another is a religious stand. Now third is an absolute stand. An absolute stand we are going there in that our absolute level. You transcend your individuality because you are no more identify your body, mind and sense organs as in deep sleep. Because it is your waking standpoint makes you see that you are an individual. Jagra drishtya tanu vyakti agi tortane ondu deshakala sambandhagalu ella baruttave. Jagra drishtiye tannalli kalpita. The very waking stand is an imposed on me. So when I look at myself without a waking stand, waking stand which is an external stand, an alien stand which is not my, which is not my real nature, because as a person within waking state, I am looking at myself in a given condition. It is a conditional state, it's not my real state. In a conditional state, I look at myself through body, through mind and sense organs, and I am present in a state, waking or dream state. This is a conditional state. But as I am, waking is only a small condition in me, and I continue to exist without waking. I continue to exist without dream and without waking. Jagradavastha illadirvagalu tanirtane, kanasu illadirvagalu tanirtane, tanna iruvike ಎಚ್ಚರಕ್ಕೆ ಪರಿಮಿತವಾಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಮೈ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಟು ವೇಕಿಂಗ್. ಮೈ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್, ಮೈ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಸಾಕ್ಷಿ, ಆಸ್ ವಿಟ್ನೆಸ್, ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಟು ವೇಕಿಂಗ್. ದೋ ಐ ಆಮ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ವಿಟ್ನೆಸಿಂಗ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದ ವೇಕಿಂಗ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ವಿಟ್ನೆಸಿಂಗ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದ ವೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್ by dropping away, by erasing my waking state and waking individuality. And even dream also same way. I can erase, I can just dismiss my dream state, I can dismiss my waking state and still stand as independent of both the states. So this independent existence of me as a non-individual, non-relative individual, because as an individual I am related. I am related to the world, I am related to people, I exist in the time and place and everything. But as I am, when I look at myself as I am in my real nature, absolute nature, I am free from the state. So that means my limited stand, external stand, through waking state is not my original stand, original nature. I just drop it off. The dream state as well as a waking state, both are only perceptions of me, not real me. So in that real me, I am a non-individual. I am not related to anybody else because there is nothing other than me. So in that absolute existence, I am the just pure consciousness, a non-individual, not a relative individual, no subject-object duality. There, see, the sin and all, the papa and punya, the good and bad karma comes into picture only in a relative state. When I am related to other, this good and bad comes into picture. So when I cease to be an individual, limited individual, when I cease to be an limited individual, that means I don't see the world other than me, like in deep sleep. The people, Ishvara and the world, all the three. Other jivas, the world and Ishvara, all these three become one with me, who himself is not an individual. Okay? An individual alone is related to other people, other jivas, and related to world, and related to Ishvara. These four, in the Vyavaharic standpoint, these four exist simultaneously. When you transcend these four in deep sleep, you have this neither. All these four don't exist for you. That means you become free from it. Once you are free from your individuality, you have no other people, other jivas. You have no the world. You don't have the world. And you don't have Ishvara also as a separate from you. Ishvara is a one, is a relative principle, who is a total principle who governs the world. The total principle is Ishvara. The law of karma is Ishvara. The whole cosmic standpoint is Ishvara. The total world as a total, the cosmos as a whole is Ishvara. But here, the cosmos is Ishvara with reference to its individual constituents within the world. See, the world becomes an Ishvara. The world as a whole becomes Ishvara to the individual particles, individual things obtained in the world. Individual jivas are governed by the whole cosmos. The law of karma, the whole cosmos governs individuals. So the whole cosmos can be called Ishvara. With reference, or the whole the state, whole the consciousness of the whole state is Ishvara, and one who is identified with a given body is a jiva. One who is the consciousness identified with a given body is a jiva, and one who is looking at the whole state is Ishvara. So here a slight deviation is done. One who is the whole state, another is an individual within the state. Here the Jiva-Ishvara relationship, an individual soul and also God. The Jiva-Ishvara relationship, Jiva is a part of Ishvara, Ishvara is a total, Jiva is one small part of it. A part is a part which is a part of the whole thing, and it can't claim independence. It has to be, it is bound by time, space and other Jivas and worldly conditions. And it acts, it does certain thing and reaches certain result. So this is a natural thing that a part is always governed by the rest of the rules. If you are a part of a system, if you are working in a company or a factory or somewhere, if as an individual you work there, you are bound by the rules of the company. Other workers are there, you have to cooperate with them, you have to adjust to them. And whatever you do, the whole company as a whole evaluates your worth of your work, and the result is awarded to you. So whatever you do, you are doing in relation with other people, in relation with your company, has a value. So a karma has a value and it produces a result. So what is that value? How do you evaluate its value in the worldly system, in the system of the world, in that relative world? Similarly, just as in the company, one company evaluates your work and gives your salary. If you suppose leave that company and goes to another company, the same amount of work you do, you will be given a different result, because the company is rich, the country is different, the situation is different, your work has got a different value, and you will get a different result. So the result depends upon the world, okay, and the laws they follow. Similarly, this system, worldly system, evaluates your karma, and it credits to the karta, the doer of it, the agent of action. The agent of action who is related to karma. So the karma is related two ways. Karma is related to karta because it is the doer who does that karma. At the same time, the karma has a value because it is a part of the world and it is related to the world and other people, other jivas. So the karma has got certain value because it is related to the world and other people. World means I'm talking of the inert world and the jivas, other jivas. So it has got certain worth and you will get that result. And there should be some principle who governs, who evaluates and sees everything, and that is Ishvara. Ishvara is the one, the conscious principle, which can see the relationship of all the relationship by a grand law of cause and effect, a grand law, all pervasive law, all governing law. That all governing principle is conscious principle is Ishvara, because it has to be conscious, it can't be mechanical. So that Ishvara evaluates the individual's acts and gives the result. So you will get good and bad results. Now this is the Jiva's, ordinary Jiva's situation. When Jiva understands this whole setup of Jiva, Ishvara, world, other Jivas, my being, Karta, all this constitutes one company or one state. If you give up, you resign from the company. Generally, you resign from the company and join in another company. So it's similarly, you give up this Janma and you assume in another birth, another life. This life, this world is like a one company. You have joined here as a one particular Jiva. And you can resign this, that means is a death. You join again another company, that means another birth you take. In another conditions you live. The principle's same. The principle, the law is same. Only you join in another company with another company. The atmosphere is different. The ecosystem is different. The situation is different. But the law is same. It gives you the award of your good and bad karmas. Okay, so this is life. But if you feel, when you feel that these are all limited and you want to understand the real nature, then you transcend the whole thing. How do you transcend? By shifting your vision. That you are an individual and a part of a company can be transcended by dropping your very individuality. Here, as long as you continue to be an individual, you are a part of a state. You are bound by the laws of the state, and you are helpless. You are bound by doing something or other. Some or other action you have to do, and then a result you have to find. There is no way, you can't escape it. You have no other choice. Choicelessly you act, and choicelessly you get some or other result. But if you understand the limitations of all this karma, karmapala, and the very individuality, being an individual itself is a situational. Because the question was like this, is this my real nature? That I am an individual, I am bound by the world, and I am bound by certain laws of time and space and the cause and effect, and I am supposed to do, I am helplessly doing some karma, some act, and I am result finding some result. Now this is the situation. Within this situation, you had some option, you could do some better work, some more religious work, and you get some better result. But even that is a result bound by cause, bound by the principle of cause and effect. But this very principle of cause and effect is limited, and you will get do some limited work and get some limited result. Then the question arose, is there no way of transcending the whole cause and effect, transcending my very individuality? Should I remain an individual only helplessly? Or is there a way that I can transcend my individuality? I can no more be an individual. I can no more be bound by cause and effect relationship. Is there such a possibility? Yes, Shastra says, there is a state in you. There is a nature in you. You can transcend your individuality and you are no more an individual. You are no more in a state. State is like a company. You are not in a company, you just drop the company because you are not an individual. So is there such a thing? Yes, such a thing is possible. That's what Shastra is teaching you. You turn your mind inwardly, you turn your mind and start looking at yourself. You look at yourself in such a way, see, there are two ways of looking. People, when they look at themselves on their own, they continue to see them as individuals alone. If you see yourself as an individual, this is one way of looking. This is, you see, it all depends upon your way of looking. See, the way of looking is most important. The way of looking is a worldly way of looking. Or the other world or the religious way of looking, whether an ordinary man's way of looking or a religious way of looking, both show you only as an individual, because both of them are within that common perception or adhyasa. Adhyasa, that I am an individual, I am related to the world, this is a common misunderstanding. So I remain within this misunderstanding and look at myself as an individual related to the world. So if I look at myself as an individual, or the way of looking, the stand which only makes me to see as an individual, doesn't help me to drop my individuality and transcend my individuality, and that doesn't help me much. It doesn't help me much, because it keeps me an individual alone. But here there is another way of looking, which is a Vedantic way of looking, not the religious way, that is a Karmakanda way. It is a Jnanakanda way. It has got totally a different outlook. It helps you to see, it guides you to see. Helps you means it guides you to look at yourself, not through the body, not through the mind, not through the sense organs, but as you are. That means first you have to learn to look at yourself through the whole state. A state, the consciousness which is watching the entire state, waking state. The same consciousness watches the entire dream state. States replace each other. Waking replaces dream, dream replaces waking. They replace each other simultaneously, leaving you totally unconnected by them. You are a total witness. Witness means you are not a part of it. Witness is not a function. Witness only shows you are not an individual. See, the idea of witness implies that you are not an individual. So you drop your individuality. How? How do you drop? You take a stand. Vedanta helps you to look at your life as a whole. The whole state you look at as a witnessing consciousness. You include your individuality, your body, your mind, your sense organs. Your individuality is also part of a state. Including your individuality in the state, look at the state as a whole. Then you are no more an individual. You cease to be an individual. You transcend your individuality. You transcend the time and space. You transcend the cause and effect relationship. You transcend the subject-object duality. You stand as a pure consciousness, free from subject-objective duality. Okay. This stand, this way of looking at yourself is the Avastatraya looking. Avastatraya view. Avastha view is the view of looking at your life through the avasthas, waking, dream, and deep sleep. Okay. So, this stand is what Vedanta teaches. So, once you take this stand and look at the avasthas, states of waking and dream, and see that they mutually exchange, they mutually cancel, they replace each other, or in other words, they cancel. Both the states, waking and dream, simultaneously cancel each other, because they don't pass through time. Time exists within the states, therefore the states exist outside the time. They are directly perceived in the sakshi. But if you take the sakshi and look at the states, state himself don't exist apart from sakshi, apart from witness. Because states have no existence independent of me as a witness, independent of the witnessing consciousness. So from the standpoint of witnessing consciousness, avasthas have no existence. Okay. So you stand free from avastha. That means you stand free from an individuality. So you are no more an individual. So then, when you are free from this individuality, you are not subject to cause and effect relation. You are not subject to any punya, good and bad karma. No, so the law of karma doesn't govern you, because you have transcended the law of karma. Law of karma no more affects you. Because the cause and effect relationship is transcended. This is what he says, nadatte kasya chit papam. So, He says, no, kasyachit papam. No, there is no, see, we have to see this difference. Accepting yourself to be individual, you deny the good and bad karma. That is an atheistic view. But at the same time, you accept yourself to be an individual, that you are a part of the world. Once you are a part of the world, once you are an individual, you can't escape the good and bad karma, punya, papa, rebirth, and all that you can't escape. You can't avoid that. But here he is talking the very transcending of individuality. When you are no more an individual, there is no state for you. There is no waking or dream or any state for you. You are just the absolute being, absolute consciousness. At that level, then there is nothing. Therefore, he says, Nadatte kasyachit papam, nachaiva sukurtam vibhu. Ishvara doesn't receive, doesn't consider, doesn't consider your punya and papa, doesn't consider your actions as good and bad. Why? Because you also don't exist as an individual. And no karmas and no karta. Therefore, there is nobody. It is a state, it is a nature where there is no karta, karma, and good and bad, and all that you transcend. Therefore, nadatte kasyachit papam, nachaiva sukrutam vibhu. Because all this is ajnane navratam yonam. The mistake, the contrast between atheistic view and Vedantic view. Atheist says you are an individual. You are a part of this world. There is a time and space. The world is there. Yet there is no good and bad karma. There is no God. Only he says there is no good and bad karma. There is no Ishvara. And there is no life after death. This is an atheist. But here when Vedantin says he is not denying Ishvara. He is not denying next birth and other world. He is not denying good and bad karmas. He is not But all this put together doesn't exist in your real nature. Because you transcended the very individuality. As an individual, other world and the rebirth, all that is inevitable, becomes inevitable. But the very individuality you give up, then you are free from the whole set of the world and other world and all that. Birth and next birth and all that. All that next birth and next birth, world and other world, all that centers on your being an individual. And your being an individual is due to your misunderstanding, a wrongly looking at yourself, taking a wrong standpoint about yourself. This wrong standpoint about yourself is adhyasa. And because of which you appear to yourself as an individual. You appear to yourself as an individual. Now here Vedanta guides you. You are seeing yourself as an individual itself is a wrong standpoint. You are not looking at yourself in your real nature from a right standpoint. See, that individuality is through body, mind and sense organs. But body, mind and sense organs are also part of the world alone, part of the state alone. Now look at the state as a whole and you are a witness. Witness is not an individual. Individual doesn't move and change. The change is karma. Individuality is karta. Changing is karma. Finding a new situation is karma phala. See, being an individual is karta. Changing is karma. Reaching another new stage is karma phala. Therefore, karta, karma, karma phala. That is being an individual, undergoing change and reaching a new experience. All these three don't exist for you. You are free from all the three. Therefore, he is shifting your vision to another level where you find that you are already free. Therefore, then why does it appear all these things? All this is due to a misunderstanding. Ajnane navratam jnanam. When you are continuing in your misunderstanding, a misperception. So therefore, that as an individual and subject to birth and death, subject to karma and all that was a misperception. Ajnane navratam jnanam. it is a misperception, a wrong perception. This wrong perception, avritam jnanam, has denied your knowledge. Wrong perception denied your knowledge, knowledge of the truth. So your real knowledge of the real the knowledge of the real truth was denied to you because of this misperception. But the truth is, you correct that ignorance. You correct that ignorance, you become free. Because you come to the right stand, the way as you are, not as you perceive through a given angle. It is just you are looking at yourself as you are. Not a wrong standpoint, as you are, then you are already free. Therefore, ajnanena avritam jnanam tena muhyanti jantavah. People are deluded because of this misperception. So the culprit is misperception. Therefore, the problem is correcting your misperception by seeing how the various states come and go in you. The you which is a witnessing consciousness, for you, the world is not separate. Okay, jnanena tu tadajnanam. But when you take this right, next shloka 16th, when you take this right standpoint with the help of the Shastra, because earlier he told in the 4th chapter, tadvidhi pranipatena pariprashnena sevaya. Go to your guru, approach him, they will teach you, and they will guide you to look at yourself in such a way where you are not an individual. See, there is another way, right way of looking at yourself. In your real self, you are no more an individual. You seeing yourself as an individual itself is a wrong. He is not teaching the individuality. He is helping you to drop the very, transcend the very individuality. People think that as an individual, I try and understand Vedanta. No. As an individual, you can't understand Vedanta. The very transcending individuality is understanding Vedanta. No. You start as an individual, but that understanding as an individual you start by looking at in a right way. The right way itself means dropping individuality. Then you become free from individuality. Then jnanena tu tadajnanam nashitam. With your right understanding, your very individual standpoint is dropped off. Atmanaha, atmanaha ajnanam nashitam. Your ignorance, your misperception is corrected. Then tesham aditya vat jnanam, his knowledge shines. Means his understanding, knowledge shines means what? His understanding of himself as a sakshi continuously shines. Shines means what? It makes you free. Tesham aditya vat jnanam prakashayati tatparam. Tesham aditya vat jnanam prakashayati tatparam. Then your knowledge of yourself shines you. Now it is not shining. Why? It is covering up. It is misrepresenting. It is giving a misperception. A misperception is not shining. Misperception is partly dimming. It is making it dim. It is distorting. Misperception is distorting. When you correct the misperception, then your understanding will be shining, because it is a natural state of you and it gives you true understanding of yourself. Therefore, tesham aditya vat jnanam prakashayati tatparam. Tat paramartha tattvam, the real nature of the atma shines. Shines means what? Spontaneously, it is self-shining. In that self-shining, you are free. Therefore, the difference is your perception and your reality. Reality is self-shining. Perception is through thought. Perception is a thought. Reality is self-shining. Therefore, drop your perception and come to your a self-shining understanding. Okay? And how to get that will be told in the next shloka, in the 17th shloka. वी विल डिस्कस दैट 17th श्लोक इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. ओके, ओम शांति शांति शांति. हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः. हरि ओम तत्सत.